الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، وبعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to the daily reminder, which is titled The Jewels from the Sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. We are still dealing with Kitab al-Adab, the Book of Manners and Etiquettes from Riyad al-Salihin by Imam al-Nawawi رحمه الله تعالى. And we come to a new heading. باب الندب إلى إتيان الصلاة والعلم ونحوهما من العبادات بالسكينة والوقار. It's a heading on the recommendation and the encouragement to approach the prayer, salah, and circles of knowledge and other acts of worship with humility, peace, and tranquility. He quotes the verse, قال الله تعالى وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. This verse in Surah Al-Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and whoever glorifies and respects the شَعَائِر, the rituals of Islam, the acts of worship in Islam, like holds them in high esteem, this is a sign of the hearts having a lot of taqwa, a lot of mindfulness of Allah, a lot of connection to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Then he quotes a hadith. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إذا أقيمت الصلاة فلا تأتوها وأنتم تسعون وأتوها وأنتم تمشون وعليكم بالسكينة أو عليكم السكينة فما أدركتم فصلوا وما فاتكم فأتموا. متفق عليه. زاد مسلم في رواية له فإن أحدكم إذا كان يعمد إلى الصلاة فهو في صلاة. So this hadith is collected by Bukhari and Muslim on the authority of Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه. He said, I heard Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم say, if the prayer is, if the إقامة is called, the إقامة for the prayer is made, do not approach the prayer while rushing, meaning trying to catch up. وَأْتُوهَا وَأَنْتُمْ تَمْشُونَ وَعَلَيْكُمُ السَّكِينَةِ. Approach it as you are walking with humility and peace. فَمَا أَدْرَكْتُمْ فَصَلُّوا وَمَا فَاتَكُمْ فَأَتِمُّوا. Whatever you catch of it, you pray that. Whatever you miss of the prayer, then you make it up. Collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim in one narration that occurs in Sahih Muslim, the Prophet ﷺ says, as long as you are approaching the prayer and you are on your way to the prayer, you are in a prayer. You are considered to be in a prayer. This means in reward, and this also means you should have the spirit of the prayer as you are approaching the prayer. Second hadith. وعن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما أنه دفع مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم عرفة فسمع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وراءه زجرا شديدا وضربا وصوتا للإبل فأشار بصوته إليهم وقال أيها الناس عليكم بالسكينة فإن البر ليس بالإيضاع. رواه البخاري وروى المسلم وروى مسلم بعضه. البر الطاعة، الإضاع بضاد معجمة قبلها ياء وهمزة مكسورة وهو الإسراع. This hadith is collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. The full wording is from Al-Bukhari. Muslim narrated parts of it. It's on the authority of Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما that he was in the company with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم as they left عرفة in Hajj. This was during Hajj. As they started leaving Arafah towards Al-Muzdalifah, the Prophet ﷺ heard behind him so much clamor and noise. And so there was like a noisy kind of commotion behind him. And the Prophet ﷺ looked behind and he pointed at these people and he said, O people, take to humility, peace and tranquility, because obedience to Allah and fulfilling the commands of Allah does not happen by this kind of clamor and rushing and this erratic approach. This is not how, you know, any act of worship is supposed to be performed. So what is this talk about? This is about how that the spirit of acts of worship, because acts of worship are a connection between us and Allah. They are actually they are moments in which we connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through our hearts. And a heart that connects with Allah needs this kind of peace, tranquility, calm, not again so much noise and chaos and clamor and so much erratic spirit. This kind of noise blocks the heart. It does not allow the heart to enter this state of tranquility and peace where it connects to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a very important thing. We have a hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam one day entered the masjid at night, and the companions of radhiyallahu anhum, some of them were at the masjid, and some of them were reading, some of them were praying, obviously qiyam al-layl, right, individually here and there, and somebody was reading, and everyone seemed to be like reciting, trying to focus in the midst of other people's recitation. Everyone was trying to recite louder in order to be able to focus so that others would recite louder, and so on and so on. So it felt like there was so much noise taking place, and that there was some sort of sense of competition over, I'm going to read louder, I'm going to want to focus, and so on and so forth. And the Prophet ﷺ said to the companions that, says to them, إِنَّ الْمُصَلِّي يُنَاجِي رَبَّهُ. The one when they pray, you are actually having a private conversation with your Lord. So focus on what you are, and pay attention to what you are saying, what you are speaking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do not speak over the others as they are praying. Do not try to recite louder than them, or compete against them in that manner. And all of this goes to point that the acts of worship are supposed to be performed in a state of humility, calm, peace, tranquility, and not rush, not trying to perform things erratically, and not trying to catch up with things. This erratic spirit goes against how prayers are supposed to be performed, again, because all of this points to the fact that acts of worship reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the heart, because when we perform acts of worship, they are supposed to come from the heart, and ultimately they feed into the heart, and from there they are supposed to go to Allah or be transferred to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if the heart is erratic, it's not paying attention. It's the nature of the heart when it connects to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to have peace and to be tranquil, as Allah says, Ala bi dhikrillahi tatma'innul qulub. Indeed, in the remembrance of Allah, the hearts feel peace. Whereas this kind of erratic state and spirit has to do with competition of this dunya and engagement with matters of this world and competition over others, and it distracts the person away from Allah, takes the attention of the person away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we approach the prayer, when we come to the prayer, we are not supposed to rush into it. We're not supposed to be like someone who's trying to catch up, someone who's falling behind and trying to catch up. But we should approach it with all peace and tranquility. Even if we are coming to the masjid or we're joining a jama'ah and we are late, we do not rush to catch the ruku', for example, which many people do. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam actually advised against that. He encouraged the opposite of this. Why? Because if you are trying to catch the ruku', you're basically counting on the numbers now. Whereas what really matters with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the quality, the spirit. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam clarified in that narration we mentioned, which is in Sahih Muslim, that as long as you are approaching the prayer, you are in a prayer. Meaning you are supposed to be in the spirit of prayer, and also you are rewarded as if you are in the prayer because you are approaching the prayer. And that's from the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it puts our hearts at ease. That's not about how much you catch now, so that you rush. Don't compromise what is important for something that is less important. All of them are important, but do not sacrifice a matter of greater importance, which is your connection to Allah through your heart and the spirit in which you perform these deeds, for the sake of catching a number. Because eventually you're going to catch it. If you fail to catch it in congregation, you're still going to perform it, and you will be rewarded as long as you did your best to catch, as long as you did your best to join the jama'ah without rushing, and again, as we said, without trying to be pushy in your approach. This takes many shapes, by the way, not only this. The example of the Prophet ﷺ in Hajj, when he saw people rushing to leave Arafah to go to Muzdalifah, and they're trying to go, like they're frantically trying to push themselves. The Prophet ﷺ said, calm down, this is not how it is supposed to be performed. You should do that with peace and tranquility. Sometimes you pray next to a person in the congregational prayer, and you find they're trying to catch, for example, Al-Fatiha, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin Ar-Rahim Malik Yawm Al-Din. Again, this is the same spirit. It's this kind of rush, this kind of being pushy about things while sacrificing your connection with Allah. This basically turns the prayer into mere pronunciation of words, just murmuring of words and movements. Whereas the most important act of the most important aspect of the prayer, which is the connection to Allah, the spirit of khushu and tranquility, is compromised. And it's not only for the person himself or herself, but even for the people around them. So this basically helps us set our priorities right. When it comes to acts of worship, the number one priority that should not be sacrificed at any expense is the state of the heart that it should be in peace, tranquility, humility, and calmness. This is how it is supposed to be performed. So it's a great etiquette, it's an important etiquette, and it's not only etiquette that is inconsequential. It's actually, it has a lot to do with the amount of reward, because the quality of our acts of worship, this is what Allah rewards us for the most. It's the quality of our connection with Allah, because that's what reaches Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us approach the acts of worship with peace, tranquility, and humility, and that He accepts those deeds from us and rewards us for them. Again, I just want to make a dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps all of us safe and keeps us in good shape and help us through these hard times and these tough circumstances. Inshallah, we'll see you in a new segment of this series. Until then, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.